Shannon Cohen. I'm the center manager at Keystone Physical Therapy in Bethel Park. I'm a physical therapist. I went to undergrad at the University of Pittsburgh and graduate school at the University of Miami in Florida. Today I'm going to be talking about understanding and preventing falls and speaking specifically why falls are such an important topic for everybody. So falls among the elderly increase healthcare use and cost. Lifetime costs associated with falls in people over 65 have been estimated at $12.6 billion. And that cost per person is over $11,800 per injury, which is huge. Some of the risk factors for falls include medications, poor vision, arthritis, poor balance, decreased strength and range of motion, and foot problems. So what exactly is balance? Balance is the ability to maintain our center of gravity within our base of support. So the center of gravity is the point in your body where your weight is evenly distributed. So that actually is right above your belly button in most people. So that's where the center point of your gravity is. Your base of support is the area enclosed by body parts in contact with the supporting surface. So essentially, your base of support is how much you can lean forward and sway while maintaining proper balance. So the greater your base of support, the more balance you're going to have. And if you can see this picture, the girl on the left-hand side has a small base of support because she's only standing on one foot, whereas the man with the walker actually has a large base of support because not only does he have his 2 feet, but also he has the legs of his walker. The center of gravity can also change with position. So in the first picture, the center of gravity is right above your belly button. But in the last picture, it actually is forward on the person. So that person may have to use a cane for balance. So how do we maintain our balance? There's 3 different ways. You have your vision, vestibular input, and somatosensory input. So visual input, which I'm sure we all know about, it allows us to align ourselves with things that we recognize. So it's really your eyes. It tells you where you are in the environment. So with that, who would have thought that vision actually plays an important part in your balance system? So if you're not receiving regular eye exams, especially over the age of 65, you really want to make sure that you are, because that's a really simple fix. You know, changing your prescription or changing some other part of your vision can really help improve your balance. Next is your inner ear, also known as your vestibular system. It helps to provide information regarding movement and equilibrium. It helps to coordinate your eye movements, and it provides information that helps us maintain an upright posture. So this system, which is pictured right there, really gives a lot of movement information. So it changes whenever you twist your head, or if you're walking up or downhill, this system is going to give different impulses to your brain, and it allows your body to react and respond appropriately so that you do not lose your balance. The last way to maintain your balance is your somatosensory input, and that's really our position sense within the body. It's based on muscle tension, joint orientation, and tension or connective tissue structures. So an example of this is if you're walking uphill, there's going to be more pressure on your calf. So your calf muscle is actually going to give that information to your body and say, okay, body, I'm now walking up a hill. On the contrary, if you're walking downhill, your calf muscle is a little bit more on slack. And so it's going to tell your body, okay, I'm walking down the hill versus up the hill. So the ability to balance is produced by the interaction of your somatosensory system, your vision, and your vestibular system. And if you have problems with any one of these systems, it may be affecting your balance. So why does this matter to you? Knowing the 3 systems that help us train, they make sure that we are not in any risky behavior that can really throw off your balance system. And if you do have a problem with one of your balance systems, you can help to train or receive treatments to improve the dysfunctional system if possible. And that's one of the things that we really do here in physical therapy is a lot of different balance training, and it really can make a huge improvement. So studies show that targeted interventions can help to reduce falls. So what does this mean to you? Some of the interventions are improving range of motion, so implementing a daily stretching program. Strengthening. If you don't have proper strength, you can't help yourself if you do go to fall or lose your balance. Balance training directly, and we're going to go through some of these exercises at the end. gait training, such as, you know, starting a walking program or getting proper training on if you're walking improperly. Maybe you need a cane, maybe you need a walker, maybe your assistive device isn't fitting you properly. Really helping with the gait training can help as well. Tai Chi is another type of exercise program that helps with balance. And we're going to go through some of the potential dangers in your own home right now that you may have. And also there's vestibular physical therapy. So range of motion, you want to make sure that you have proper range of motion in your ankles, hips, trunk, and neck. And you can achieve these through stretching. And also if you are having problems with maybe osteoarthritis, you can see your doctor or a physical therapist can help you to improve your range of motion. So as you can see in this picture, the woman walking, if you don't have adequate hip range of motion, you actually won't be able to walk properly. You may be tight and that can lead to falls. Same with the upper trunk. Trying to keep your shoulders back and keeping your upper chest upright can actually help your upper extremity movement, like your arms. And also, if you do have rounded shoulders and a forward head, that is going to cause the rest of your body to go forward and can actually throw off your balance as well. So strengthening programs, lower extremity strengthening plays an important role in fall reduction. And we're going to go through some of the exercises that you can do at home at the end. Really strengthening your hip, your ankle, and your knees as well can also help to reduce falls. And actually, balance can improve with practice. So whenever you first start balance training, you want to put your feet further apart at first and then work into areas where your feet are closer together. Because the closer your feet are together, the harder the exercise is going to be. Standing on a firm surface, starting out with the balance training is going to be a lot easier. And then going to a softer surface will help actually train for the environment, like walking on grass or walking on like a rocky surface, which will definitely be a little bit harder. When you're doing balance training, safety really is the biggest issue. Please don't practice balance training unless you have somebody there with you to help hold you up. Or if you feel that you can do it at home, you want to hold on to a chair just in case. You never know. Some other exercises to address balance are a Swiss ball program, which is a large ball. A pool is a great place to practice exercises because if you fall, you're going to hit the water. Hopefully not the side of the pool. Also, you can do aerobics and dancing. I know a lot of individuals do Zumba, which is great for balance as well. Studies have shown Tai Chi to have a positive impact on balance. It enhances both your balance and your body awareness. It also can help to improve other factors in your body, such as blood pressure. Walking programs. If you're not walking right now, you should be, especially now during the summer. It's beautiful outside. Really starting to walk is going to help your overall health and also can help to improve balance. If the cement is too hard for you, walking on a track or out even on the Montour Trail is a great place to walk because it's not so hard like the cement, which may be outside. And it's also fun to walk with a friend, so it can improve your psyche as well. So let's talk about fall preventions at home. First, you want to look around your home and see, do you have a lot of space to walk? Is your house maybe a little bit more cluttered and you need to get rid of some things? Throw rugs are one way that you can trip. You know, I tell everybody, get rid of your throw rugs. They may look pretty, but they're a hazard and they're very easy to fall on. If you have a pet, such as a cat or a dog who tends to lay right in the doorway like my little dog does, you know, make sure you're watching for them. Make sure you're not tripping on your pets. Also, you don't want to hurt them if you do trip on them. Magazine racks, another great way to trip. If you have these, please move them behind your chair or out of the way so they're not right in your main way where you're walking. Another thing are cords and cables. Even at night, maybe you've had your alarm clock plugged in and the wire has gone across this one area for 10 years, but you forget about it. It's a great way to trip, so moving those out of the way is very important. Ensuring adequate lighting and accessibility to switches. Now, I know this is a big deal, especially at night. Maybe you go to the bathroom frequently at night. Lighting up the way to the bathroom and lighting up the way back can really help to prevent falls. I know that's a major time when people fall. So I know they even have these little lights that require no plugs. They just use like natural energy to turn themselves on. Just putting little lights along the wall on the way to the bathroom can really help to prevent falls. Removing clutter. remove your clutter, put your clothes away, get your things out of the room so that when you are walking, you don't have to worry about tripping on things. Having a fear of falling is a huge thing also. So if you can prevent that, that's going to help to prevent falls. Arrange furniture to allow easy access to the bathroom. And I think we sort of already discussed this, but if you have extra furniture, donate it. Get it out of the way. You want to really make sure that you are having enough space to walk through your own home. And slippery surfaces should be treated with non-slip covers. I know this can be a problem with like decks outside, if the wood is a little bit slippery. So what you can do is just get like a little bit of some sort of durable surface that you can just staple onto the steps, like sandpaper or something, and I'm sure at Home Depot they can help to show you which ones to do, but really it's an inexpensive way, and the cost of falls is so significant. If you can, you know, disperse that cost by spending $10 at Home Depot versus, you know, $11,800 a year, you absolutely should do it. And it's gonna help to prevent you pain as well. So just some general tips. You wanna watch for dizziness with position changes. It may signal blood pressure changes. And if this does happen to you, you should talk to your doctor about it. Wearing proper footwear during all physical activities and really at home as well. You know, if you wear slippers which are old and they're not great, they don't have great grips, you know, wear some proper footwear. Put on your tennis shoes. I know they make extremely comfortable tennis shoes now, so really there's no excuse not to wear proper footwear. If you do have multiple falls, you should talk to your doctor about it or come see a physical therapist and we can determine the best course of treatment for you. You know, falling is not a normal part of aging, and if you are having difficulty with it, you should definitely get help. So exercise and falls prevention really go hand in hand.
Falling in the home is very common and is dangerous. Luckily, it's very preventable.
Many health problems increase the chance of falling in the home. Talk to your doctor about possible health problems that could increase your risk of falling.
Wearing the right shoes can go a long way in fall protection. Wear properly fitting, sturdy shoes with non-skid soles. Avoid wearing high heels, flimsy slippers, and shoes with slick soles.
Staying physically active can also decrease the chance of falling. With a doctor's okay, consider activities that improve strength, balance, and coordination.
There are many ways to make your home safer as well. Clearing walkways of cords or boxes, securing loose rugs with double-faced tape or slip-resistant backing, and using non-slip mats in your bathtub or shower all help.
There are many things to consider towards fall prevention. Talk to your doctor about other possible ways to prevent falls.
Now I'm going to work with Chris, and he's going to do a few exercises that you can do every day at your own home, and they really can help to prevent falls. This is Chris Amadeo. He's our patient service specialist. He's going to be going through and demonstrating some of the exercises that you can do in your own home to improve your balance. So the first exercise you're going to do, always hold on to a chair if you feel unsafe. It definitely can help with balance. So Chris is going to hold on to the back of this chair, and he's going to lift one leg up to a 90 degree position. Now, one thing that you can do is if you have a gait belt, which is a belt that you can put around yourself for safety, you can have another caretaker or your husband or wife hold on to you while you're doing this exercise. So that way, if Chris does go to fall, I can catch him with the gait belt. The best way to do this exercise is 10 times for 10 seconds. So he's gonna hold that leg up for 10 seconds and then put it back down. And then he can do that again for another 10 seconds. Now to make this exercise harder, what Chris can do is actually lift one hand up and do the same thing 10 times for 10 seconds. The second exercise Chris is going to do is actually turn to face the camera, point your feet together, hold on to the chair, and then stand there for 10 seconds. And again, I can hold on to him from the front and the back or just the back with the gait belt. And this really challenges your balance system. The less balance you have, the more sway you're going to have. Chris can make this exercise harder by closing one eye or by closing both eyes, but make sure you're very safe when doing this exercise. The next exercise Chris is going to do is put one foot in front of the other. And again, you want to hold on to the chair if you are doing this by yourself at home. and try to do the right foot in front, and then try the left foot in front. And if one's harder than the other, then that may mean that you need to practice a little bit more on the side that you feel more wobbly on. And again, doing this for 10 times for 10 seconds can really help to improve your static balance. The next exercise that you can do can really help to prevent falls are simple heel and toe raises. So what Chris is going to do is spread his feet shoulder width apart. He's going to lift his heels up off of the ground and then go back down. Holding onto the chair if you feel like you need to for balance, or if not, then you could do it without holding onto the chair as well. You want to do about 30 of these, keep going, 30 of these every day. And that will really help strengthen your calf muscle, which is one of the muscles that help you with balance. And I like to do this whenever I'm drying my hair in the morning or really at any time during the day. It's just sort of a fun thing to do. The next exercise we're going to do is actually a calf stretch. So Chris is going to turn and face his chair. You're going to put one foot in the front and one foot in the back. And notice his knee is straight. And this is a calf stretch, so he's gonna try to lean down as far as he can, and you should really feel a stretch in the back of the calf. Any stretch you do, you wanna hold for 30 seconds. That's the minimum amount of time required to lengthen a muscle. So this is really stretching out his right calf. And really, you wanna make sure you do both sides so that you're even. So Chris is gonna go ahead and hold this for 30 seconds. Now, if you feel unsafe, again, you can have your caretaker or somebody hold onto the belt. This is a pretty safe exercise in general. Another exercise that's great for balance and actually really great for strength as well is a squat. Now, you want to make sure you're doing your squats carefully. And so Chris actually is going to stand in front of the chair whenever he performs his squat. Now, Chris is going to stick his butt back, not forward, and pretend to sit down, but actually he's not going to sit down on the chair. And then come back up. And you want your feet about shoulder width apart, and you want your knees to point straight. You don't want your knees to come together or pull apart. And you want to keep your chest and your shoulders up. Now, if this exercise is too hard, what you can actually do is go ahead and sit down and then stand back up. And this is a great exercise to do whenever you're watching TV or, you know, just whenever you're out in public. You know, it's kind of a great exercise for your quads and helps to stabilize yourself. The last exercise we're going to do is a stretch. So it's a stretch for the back of your leg called your hamstrings. So Chris is gonna go ahead and sit down and straighten out his right leg. And then keeping his knee straight, he's going to lean down, keeping his knee straight. He's going to try to touch his toes. And he's actually having a little bit of a difficult time with this. So his hamstrings are a little bit tight. And again, you wanna hold this stretch for 30 seconds. And do it on both sides. So that's all for the exercises. Thank you so much for sitting through this presentation. Thank you, Chris, for demonstrating. And if you do have any questions, feel free to call. Our phone number is 412-831-2060. And my email address is on the screen as well. If you have any questions, feel free to email me. Thank you so much.